myself personally about my application.
Sorry, can you repeat your name?
I'm John Aiken from Reuters News Agency. Mr. Rose, do you have any regrets personally about the publication of the cartoons? And beyond that, do you think you and your newspaper bear any responsibility for the violence that erupted afterwards?
I don't regret being the agent who, in a way, played a role in initiating this publication. Of course, I do believe that no cartoon is worth a single human life. Unfortunately, there are some other people who think otherwise. When it comes to responsibility, I take responsibility for publishing those cartoons, but it's not the same as taking responsibility for, you know, possible violence. And one of the things I've been thinking a lot about for the past 5 years is, for instance, when I read in the New York Times and on the newspapers, the Danish cartoons that ignited violence in the Middle East. It's a phrase that journalists use quite often. And by phrasing it that way, you write out the perpetrators of the story. It is as if there is an automatic, immediate connection between cartoons and Muslim violence. And I happen to believe that Muslims are individuals, they have a mind, they're able to reason and make decisions. And the fact of the matter is that the violence was committed by people who made a decision to react to these cartoons in a specific way. To publish cartoons, religious satire in a Danish newspaper is not the initiation of violence. And that there is no logical or immediate or dramatic, it's not Pavlov's dogs. You just push a button and then you get a reaction. So, just to put it into a broader context, it's in fact one of the key points in my book, because by phrasing it this way, we tend to equalize words and actions, or you erase the distinction between an image and the reaction to an image. And if you talk about democracy, I mean, what we have in democracy is we need words with words, or to answer images with images. What is not allowed in democracy is to use violence as an argument against ideas or against opinions that you don't like. And I really believe that when people write, you know, cartoons that ignite violence in the Middle East, you tend to erase the distinction between words and actions. And in a way, that brings us back to the time before the Reformation, when verbal attacks on the church were perceived as physical attacks. And that's why you burn heretics on the state, because they were perceived as threats to the social peace. And I don't want to live in that kind of world. So I think we should be very careful to